Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to understand cache coherence problem. So this problem we come across in our computers when the computers are of this kind of architectures. So which means whenever multiple processors with independent caching memories are trying to access some common main memory. So what it means is whenever multiple processors with independent caching memories trying to access common main memory, then we are going to get this problem. So the problem is cache coherence problem. So what this problem is, for example, we'll try to understand this with an example. For example, the main memory is having a variable called x, and this x is stored with a value x. 10 with a value 10, and at some point of time this variable x is accessed by c1. So c1 has accessed this 10, and in the process of executing that program, it made changes on this variable x, and it has been changed, it has been decremented from 10 to 9. So one value it is getting decremented, so the 10 is made 9. So immediately after changing this, we have to update that value. Before updating that value, for example, if the cache C2 has accessed that value of x, so we haven't updated the value of x from 10 to 9. So in the process of updating, so between the process of updating the value of x on the main memory with the value of x in the cache memory, if C2 is trying to access the value of x and it has accessed the value of x, so now the C2 is having the value of x. So whatever the operation that C2 is trying to do, it will be made on the value 10. So this is trying to bring inconsistencies. So what it means is, for example, if this has incremented the value of x with 2, so now this has been made 2 times incremented, means it is going to be 12. Okay, so now after some time this will get updated. So it has been updated to 9 after some time this has been updated to 9, and after that this has been updated to 12. So but what the value of x should actually be? So what the value of x, if it is done properly, means, so what it has to be means, for example, initially the value of x is 10. So it has C1 has accessed that value and it has made some changes on that value. So it so immediately, if it immediately updates the value of x from 10 to 9, and after that if C2 has accessed the value, what is the actual value of x? The actual value of x is 9, because the value 10 has been updated by C1. Okay, so after updating, if C2 accesses 8 and it has incremented the value of 9 by 2, 9 has been incremented 2 times. So actually what the value of x should be, will be 11, but what we got, it is 12. So this is what we call it as inconsistencies are created, and this problem is what we call it as cache coherence problem. Okay. So this is all about cache coherence problem. In our next video, we'll try to understand how to avoid cache coherence problem. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. And if you feel that this video is helpful to you, please give us a like symbol, and please share this video with your friends so that they will also get benefited. Thanks for watching.